I am not comfortable with statistic and hypothesis. I am not able to develop hypothesis. Okay, fine, good. It is not your forte. Okay, come and meet me. I'll give you the topic of content analysis. You do content analysis. There are various software available. Okay, but try to identify, try to communicate, try to listen, try to read, and develop good research design. At the stage of research, can consider three important aspects. At the stage of research, these are the three important aspects. First is problem statement. Whenever, whatever problem you are facing, you must go for scientific investigation with the help of objective. Basically, there are two types of objective, primary objective and secondary objective. You can take the help of your topic become your objective. So you have to prepare your objective. And with objective, you should specify what is your aim. Suppose here I have mentioned one issue. Investment pattern of academician with special reference to South Gujarat. Okay, I don't want to know the investment pattern of investor. I just want to know investment pattern of academician. So I have to create hypothesis for them. There is no significance relationship between academician. There is a significance relationship between academician as far as investment is concerned. So you have to develop hypothetical solution of your problem. So you should focus on these three aspects. So whenever you are formulating the problem, it means you are stating the problem in a way that you are doing research. You are able to solve the problem. A research problem is simply the research topic. Yes, your research problem is simply the research topic. Need to reproduce, need to re-engineer the topic and clearly state what is intent to be explored about the topic. You must specify your intent, what you want to do, how you want to do. Then formulate your questions. Your research may start as a general idea or specific questions, statement or thesis. Know what you want to focus on before you begin. Yes, know what you want to focus. Know what you want to do. If you want to do the study on consumer behavior, okay, fine. If you want to know the impact of COVID-19 on employee engagement, yes. Okay, if you want to know why people are scared about COVID-19, if you want to know the importance of six feet distance, so you should specify and you should focus what you want to do. Impact, you want to do the study on stock market, impact of calendar anomalies on Indian stock market. Okay, fine, you can, but try to characterize. Once the research problem is formulated, the topic becomes ready for undergoing a scientific inquiry. So you should focus on problem, formulate the problem, and take initiative. There are certain characteristics of formulating the statement. First is address a gap in knowledge. Whenever you are preparing problem, you should address the gap in knowledge. Because you are increasing your knowledge, increase your stock of knowledge with the help of LR, with the help of availability of resources. It should be significant enough to contribute to the existing body of research. Yes, you have to check the level of contribution. Then it should be lead to further research. Whenever you are doing, nowadays people are just doing copy and go for pattern. No need to go for unethical practices. Are you getting my point? Ethics in research, ethics in life. There are certain standardized principles you have to follow whenever you are doing research. Problem should be rendered itself to investigate. Yes, you should render the problem and put into the investigation mode through collection of data. There are many techniques available for getting information. So you should get the information. You should collect the data with the help of field study, with the help of field survey. Identify the problem according to his or her skill. Yes, must work on skill, must work on your interest. Identify your skill, identify your interest area. Identify the availability of resources. everything is available, yes, okay, fine, you should go ahead. But try to understand what is your skill, as well as try to understand the skill of research scholar. Availability of time, availability of resources, and the approach towards solving the problem should be ethical, as we have discussed. So whenever you are discussing on the problem statement, you should focus on, rather than focusing on broad area, you must narrow down such specific topic. For example, researcher want to do the research on domestic violence. Okay. For example, researcher want to do research on topic called domestic violence. This is a broad area. You know that this is your responsibility. You can divide this broad topic, or you can split down this topic into narrow topic. Okay, for example, profile of family in which domestic violence occur, profile of victim of domestic violence, cause of domestic violence, type of domestic violence, impact of domestic violence on family, service is available for the victim of domestic violence, effectiveness of services provided to victim of domestic violence. Okay, so you have to split down your domestic violence in different categories. And now you can start research. So whenever you are writing any problem, whenever you are formatting any problem, whenever you are writing any problem, usually you should writing, or problem is usually written in three parts. First step, research problem, it usually written in three parts. First is ideal part. Second part is reality. And third part is consequences. I'll give you the example also. So whenever you are writing any problem, you must take care of all the three parts. First thing is ideal. It become ideal, it become common. You just copy and paste. You have to explain the topic, meaning of topic, how things should be done. Second, you should explain the reality. Describe the condition that prevent the goal, state and values in the part A. The common thing you should describe with specific goal or with the help of ideal situation. And third, the consequences. Identify the way you propose to improve the critical situation. Okay, let's try to see the example. Several research studies were conducted in the area of investment and saving pattern of individual in their preferences for investment avenue on the risk return and demographical attributes. You know that is very common. It is very ideal. It means it is very common and it is ideal statement. Everything, whenever you are searching any literature review related to investment and saving, you may get these two lines. It is very common, it is very ideal. Second, the investment pattern classification is based on the involved risk and return associated with the prevailing investment. So it is the reality. And third part, consequences. To fulfill the need for establishing a study on investment pattern of academician, consider as an extension to research attempt would be the attempt to comprehend to investment pattern the level of risk and return and investment purpose. So it becomes consequences. So you may divide your problem in these three parts. Now, second most important thing is literature review. Whenever we are doing research, you must focus on the most important part. As I said, that it is the heart of research. First thing is, once the research problem is defined and identified, the next step is to review the existing research. You may go for the review. There are various sources available, secondary sources. With the help of secondary sources, you can take the help of Google, you can take the help of Sod Ganga, you can take the help of Sod Gangatri. There are different types of search engines available. You can take the help of search engine for writing the research paper or identifying the literature review. So the researcher must review the literature related to the research problem. Yes, you must review the literature related to the research problem. Whenever you are writing anything, you must focus on how I can get the relevant document. The review of literature also educate the researcher about what study have been conducted in the past. Yes, what study have been conducted in the past. So you can take the base. You can take the help of past study. and reveal something new, exploring something new. How this study were conducted, and when it is conducted, where it is conducted, how it is conducted. You should work on that part and identifying the research gap. We will definitely come to that part also. Identify the gap also. So how this study were conducted and contributed. I'll add one more topic. How this study were conducted and contributed. The conclusion in the problem area. Yes, you have to conclude. You need to understand. You can carefully read the conclusion. And understand the conclusion contribution in the development of research in the problem area. Get background information. Read about your topic using website or secondary sources available to help you focus on the key elements and can help you to decide the broaden or narrow your focus. Should focus on the key elements: historical background, current research context, relevant theories, concept, definition of relevant terminology, research gap, supporting evidence of practical problem. These are the elements. Whenever you are doing detailed study of review of literature, you should focus on this. So these are the things, these are the key elements which are directly help you out to solving or formulating the problem. Actually, the literature review start even before the formulation of research aim and objective. Parallelly, you can start to check if exactly the same research problem has been addressed before or not. You have to check. If it is addressed, so you can identify the gap. If it is not, okay, you can start, you can explore. Okay, so these are the importance of research review of literature. We will definitely look into that in detail. So when we are talking about research design, it's a blueprint of any research paper, any thesis or any dissertation, the blueprint for fulfilling the objective and answer of specific questions. Basically, there are three types of research design: exploratory research design, descriptive research design, and causal research design. As far as exploratory research design is concerned, you should focus on plan, you should focus on strategy, and you should focus on structure. Okay, for investigation of purposive answer of specific questions. So research design specific the method and produce and procedure for conducting a particular study. Yes, it will help with the help of research design. With the help of research design, you have to specify your method. Either you can use exploratory or descriptive or causal research with the help of process, with the help of procedure for conducting a particular study in respective of any field. Broadly speaking, research design can be grouped into three categories: exploratory, descriptive, and causal research. What do you mean by exploratory? Exploratory name itself suggests you have to explore. Creating discovery of new idea, creating new idea with the help of secondary data. Preliminary investigation, which does not have a rigid design, that you know. And to change his focus as a result of new idea and relationship among the variable. In that case, you can go for exploratory research design. For example, exploratory factor, you are doing factor analysis of any topic, or you are using service quality model, you can use exploratory research design. But in social science, most of the research are based on descriptive research. What do you mean by descriptive research? To know the characteristics of certain group, you need to know, you have to do detailed study, description, describe something. You want to know the age, gender, qualification, income, occupation, family status. You may use descriptive design. Then next important part of design, that is causal research design. What actually mean by causal research design? Causal research design means to know the cause and effect relationship, to know the cause and effect, to know the independent and dependent relationship between two or more variable, between two or more phenomena, you can use causal research design. Impact of income on purchasing power. Okay, so you have to identify the cause and effect variable. Okay, impact of income and expense. If income goes up, expense goes up. If income goes down, your expense goes down. So you have to identify the relationship between two different variables, two different phenomena. Fine. Now, the next important part of research, that is formulating hypothesis. Now, I can give you the best example of hypothesis. You may divide hypothesis what in two parts. First is hypo, H-Y-P-O plus thesis. Hypo means tentative, and thesis means solution of your problem, or you can say that draft. So hypothesis means what? It is a tentative solution of your problem on the basis of assumption. Are you getting my point? So hypothesis is an assumption that is made on the basis of some evidence. The hypothesis should be clear and precise to consider to be reliable. There are two types of hypothesis: null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis with the help of 5% significance level. You know that if hypothesis is relational hypothesis, then you should be starting with the relationship between different variables. There are basically common two types of variable: independent variable and dependent variable. So the relationship between independent variable and dependent variable. If, for example, if you eat more vegetable, you will lose your weight faster. Here, the eating more vegetable is independent variable, and losing weight is independent. It's a very common example. Okay, fine. So basically, there are, apart from these two variables, there are more three variable, and which are having unique characteristic. First common two variable is independent variable and dependent variable. Third important types of variable is moderating variable. It help in modifying the relationship between independent variable and dependent variable. This is the third type of variable, that is moderating variable. Fourth type of variable called extraneous variable. It with the help of extraneous variable, you may have identified the little impact on dependent variable, and if these variables are not control variable, it is called extraneous variable. And fifth type of variable we called as a interweaving variable. We never identify the direct impact. Are you getting my point? We never identify the direct impact. That is called interweaving variable, and this interweaving variable is linkage between independent variable and dependent variable. Okay, so these are the different. So whenever you are framing hypothesis, you should understand and you should focus on three important aspects while you are compelling and while you are building hypothesis. First, clearly define the topic and focus of experiment. Yes, you may clearly define what you want to identify and how you can identify and how you can solve. Try to write the hypothesis as if then statement. Specify the action is taken. Outcome is expected. You know that either it is accepted or rejected. Outcome is accepted. We know that. But still, we need to understand impact of qualification on brand. Impact of qualification on brand, for example, we know that. But impact of status on brand, of course, but we know that. We can easily distinguish between two variables. Impact of qualification on and brand. Maybe there is no relationship exists between qualification and brand. Yes, definitely the relationship exists between the status, societal status and brand. Are you getting my point? So outcome, we know the outcome. We are expecting the outcome and should define the variable. So these are the three important compelling why you are preparing hypothesis. Any questions? Any questions to anyone? Okay, now. Sources of data collection. This is very important part. Sources of data. Basically, there are two types. Basically, there are two types of sources. First is primary sources and secondary sources. And it is very important for the researcher to decide whether he or she has to collect primary data or dependent exclusively on secondary data. So you should specify which technique you have to use, either primary or secondary. Whenever, once you decided, if you go with the primary data, you have to develop well-structured questionnaire. And now you have specified, yes, I want to go with secondary data. There are various techniques available for getting information. Three things required: internet, laptop, and electricity. For secondary data, these three things is required: internet, laptop, and electricity. If you are having these three things, you can easily get the data. Okay. So sometimes research studies based on both the data, primary data and secondary data. Primary data, what kind of information to be collected, from where this information to be collected. Primary data through two approach: observation, survey. Whenever you are using survey method having three different types. First is personal interview, we call as a PI, one-to-one interaction. You can ask questions, they will answer your questions. Telephoning, with the help of directory, you may call them and you can get the response. Fine. And mail interview, we just have to shoot the mail regarding all the questions, regarding responses. Fine. So these are the three unique methods of survey and observation method. It is very common. Two types of observation: direct observation and indirect observation. Indirect observation, you should communicate and you should pass the information. Yes, we are there observing you. In indirect observation, it is indirect. No need to disclose what you are doing, what you are observing. Okay. Secondary data information. Basically, why we need to go for secondary data information, and what is the basic difference between secondary data and primary data? Primary data are more reliable than secondary data. We know that, but primary data is time consuming process. Okay, it is costliest process. When you are dealing with the primary data, it is costliest affair. Are you getting my point? So basically when we are talking about secondary data, it satisfies the oneself that the data are quite suitable for objective split out by the study. How we can get the secondary data? Basically, secondary data having two types: internal sources and external sources. Okay, you can get the data within the company, you can get the data outside the company. So everything is based on your aim, everything is based on your objective, everything is based on what you want to collect. And primary data, it's a phrase-ended information. It is depend on your field survey. It is depend on the quality of research. It is depend on the quality of questions. It is depend on what you want to collect. It is depend on your problem. Sampling tactic. This is also very important. Okay. This is very important. Sampling technique. Through that, you can get your result. Through that, you can analyze your result. You may divide your sample into different area: population, sample, sample frame, sample design, probability sampling, non-probability sampling. These are the two types of probability sampling, probability sampling and non-probability sampling. What do you mean by population? Everybody know what do you mean by population. It applied to know infinite or finite collection of individual. You cover whole world. To cover each and every person. What is sample? It's a subset of population. What is sample frame? It's an element from which the sample is actually drawn. The framework of road and then sampling design. Sampling design have two types: probability sampling and non-probability sampling. What do you mean by probability sampling? You may give equal chance for being selected as a sample unit. That is called probability sampling. If we toss a coin, there is a chance of getting head and tail. That is called probability sampling. Probability sampling having different types. Non-probability sampling having different types. We are using non-probability sampling because we don't have time. We are stuck with some limitation. So we have to follow that limitation. And that's why we are using non-probability sampling technique. So the unit of population have unequal or negligible, almost no chance for being selected as a sample unit. There is a chance of repeatedness also. So this is the example of sampling. You can see this. This become your target population and this become your sample. You can see the sample. Okay. And small n represent your sample and capital N represent your population. So what actually mean by sampling, that you know very well. It is a subset of population. Sampling method divided into two parts: probability sampling and non-probability. Sampling, probability sampling having four types: simple random sampling, it's a peak and span. Systematic random sampling, 1, 3, 5, 9. stratified sampling, you divide according to the strata. Cluster, you divide according to cluster, according to area. Fine, so simple random, you can see the image. Simple random sampling, systematic random sampling from 2, 4, 6, 7, 2, 4, 6, 8. It's called systematic sampling. Stratified sampling, you can divide according to the age, you can divide according to quota, you can divide according to the characteristic, that is called stratified sampling. What is cluster? According to area. I can take 50 from Surat, I can take 50 from Baroda, I can take 50 from Ahmedabad, I can take 50 from Navsari, I can take 50 from Tamil Nadu. Are you getting me? So you divide according to the cluster. Then non-probability sampling. Non-probability sampling.
Please mute yourself. And Mr. Gopal sir, one of the participants, stop presenting the screen, sir. Gopal sir, please stop presenting the screen. Sir Gopal sir, please stop presenting the screen. Okay, thank you. Sir, please go ahead, sir.
Okay, sorry, fine. For the interruption. Not an issue, man. Now, non-probability sampling. Non-probability sampling, having convenient sampling according to your conveniency, according to the conveniency of researcher, according to the conveniency of a scholar, according to the time horizon, you may get the data. That is called convenience. So you have to specify which sampling technique you are using, either non-probability or probability, but you should specify that this technique we are using for getting information. Voluntary response sampling method. No, judgmental sampling method, purposive sampling method. We are having some specific purpose. You should specify your purpose and according to get the data. And snowball sampling, it's a referencing style. You are using reference. You can take the reference from the participant, from the audience. And so insurance people are using this particular method called snowball sampling. Now, how you can design the collection instrument, that is called questionnaire. There are two types of questionnaire, structured questionnaire and unstructured questionnaire. So step number five, whenever you are preparing or whenever you are formulating or whenever you are drafting your thesis, try to understand which data collection instrument you are using. Questionnaire are the set of questions to be investigated predefined problem. You have already defined the problem. Now you may convert your problem into questions and your questions may give you answer. But how you can? So for that, we are having two types. One is structure questionnaire and another is unstructured questionnaire. Structure questionnaire having sequence. We have already defined all the questions in a proper manner, on a sequencing manner. And no sequence defined. You can ask any question. We call it as unstructured questions. So you should keep, researcher has to keep in mind proper wording. Many times I heard they are not using proper word. Whenever you are preparing questionnaire, I would like to request each and every participant, each and every research scholar should mention your declaration paragraph, should write your declaration paragraph on the top of questionnaire. And in that declaration paragraph, you have declared that I am the student of so-and-so, I am doing the research, I am doing PhD, I am doing project, or I am doing a proposal, or I am doing anything from so-and-so college, and this particular research is only for education purpose, not for another purpose. You should specify this importance, should write at least, and the wording. Second, the quality of question while designing the questions. You should specify what you want to do. Questions can be open-ended, it can be open-ended, it can be closed-ended. Pre-testing of questionnaire is always required before the actual survey is conducted. Yes, you have to do pre-testing. You have to do pilot testing. You have to select few respondents from the field and do the pre-testing. And you can remove the conflicting question. You remove the emotional questions. So in this way, you have to prepare your instrument of data collection. Then organize and conducting the field survey. You have to organize how you can conduct the survey. This is not a right time to get the information. No one allow you come and bring the information. So in that case, what you are doing, you have to prepare Google form. You can use any other sources of collecting response, sources of getting information. So at least you should prepare online, offline questionnaire, hard copy and soft copy of questionnaire. Select your sample, select your design, select your area. And then once you prepare, after completion of pre-testing, now next step is organizing and conducting field survey. Field study is different and field survey is different. Both are different. So two important aspects should be looked into: interviewing and the supervision of field work. Yes. Need to do mentoring. These are the two important aspects. Need to do mentoring. Give training to them. What to do, how to, what to do, how to do, when to do. You should prepare WH questions for that also. Not for interviewer, but for researcher also. Supervise them. If they are doing something wrong, please correct them. Yes, no, you can do in this way. You can get data very quickly and very easily. So the task of interviewing seems to be simple, but in reality, you know that it is very difficult to get the data. Are you getting my point? Supervision of fieldwork is equally important to ensure the timely and properly completion of the field survey. That is very common to everyone. Okay, next. Most critical part of
Hello.
It. Yes.
Hello. Yeah. Yes, sir. Your screen is not visible. Sorry for the interruption.
Ma'am, you can see the presentation, ma'am, because some other person has interrupted the presentation in between. That's why his screen went off.
Now it is visible. Okay, ma'am. It's okay. Fine. Now it is visible.
Yes. 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 It is visible. Yes.
Okay. Fine. Thank you, ma'am. Okay. Now we know that it is very important. It is important and it is very critical task of any researcher and for any researcher. Okay. Editing, tabulation, classification, and coding of data. Are you getting my point? Biggest task and critical task for any researcher. You are able to collect. You can easily collect data with the help of completeness, with the help of consistency, with the help of quality, with the help of accuracy. You can ensure everything while collecting data. Now it is the time to examine the raw data to detect error and omitted the error. So your task, the task of researcher, the task of scholar, try to omit, try to detect error and resolve that error with the help of four characteristics, that is quality, completeness, consistency, and accuracy. You have to check accuracy of the data also. You have to check completeness of data. Is there any missing value? You can try to get the data back. So need to complete all the things. Consistency in the data. You will have to check before collecting original data. Apart from ensuring quality data, this will be facilitated to coding and tabulation. Yes, it is very important. It will directly facilitate for the coding and tabulation. Once you complete editing part, now next part is you have to do coding. What do you mean by coding? Coding means assigning some symbol, alphabeticals or numerical or both, to answer particular questions. You can record it into the limited number of class or category. For example, what is your gender? What is your sex, male and female? So what you can do, now you may assign 0 to male and 1 to female. It is very common for everyone. But try to understand, this is very important. You have to prepare two things over here. One is code book and code sheet. You have to prepare two things, code book and code sheet. Male 0, female 1. This is your code book. Okay, now you can prepare code sheet. In that code sheet, you can do coding of all the data. of question. Then classification of data. Classification according to attributes. Classificate according to the numerical characteristics. Depend. And then you can use statistical analysis or statistical series of data with the help of tabulating, with the help of chart, with the help of graphical presentation. Fine. You may use different table, you may use different graph and present your research, present your data collection. Are you getting my point? And next, once you collect the data, once you analyze the data, once you feed the data in computer, okay, or in software, now you should analyzing the data with the help of statistical analysis. Either you can use mean value, you can identify mean, median, mode, correlation, regression, in respective of any field. But try to understand what is your objective. Keep your objective in your mind and start data analysis. And whenever you starting your data analysis, it involves reducing the accumulated data, manageable the size, developing the summaries, looking for the pattern, and applying the statistical technique. You should understand what you want to do. And relevant measure of central trends. You know that all the statistical different statistical tools available for analysis. You can take the help and do the analysis. Last. You may identify with the help of statistical analysis, you may derive your findings, conclusion, and suggestion. Write down your findings. Whatever you find, it must be clear, it must be concise and feasible. So whatever you are found, you have to represent in the sense of conclusion. And conclusion is based on the result and data analysis. Conclusion is based on your findings. Okay, then suggestion. You may give the suggestion on the basis of findings. You may give the suggestion on the basis of your conclusion. Okay, and take the actions. And give some recommendation, give some suggestion to the company, to the person, to the higher authority, according to real and ethical survey. Okay. Report writing. Most important. Last topic, I can say that this is the last finalized part of research. Okay, formatting. You know that type, size of paper, length, depth, report, pattern, paragraph, intent, number, font size, typing, color, binding of that thesis, soft copy, hard copy. Keep your soft copy. Safe place. Keep your hard copy at safe place. Okay, you can use proper material, you can use proper color, you can use proper quality. These are the important steps of research. So now we are talking about the most important part, that is identification of problem. Till now we are just understanding the step you have to follow for completing your thesis, dissertation, or proposal or research paper. Now you will have to identify, you will have to formulate the research. I just give you an example. Millions people saw the apple fall. Millions people saw the apple falls, but Newton was the one who asked why. Are you getting my point? It's a pretty example for researcher. Million people saw, I'll just repeat that statement. Million people saw the apple falls, but Newton was the one who asked why. If we would have new knowledge, we must get a whole world of new questions. You can ask new questions to yourself. Okay, why I want to do this study? That's why I just come with new topic called problem identification. Whenever you are preparing your research problem, whenever you are identifying the research problem, at least you should ask these questions. First, what is the problem identification research methodology? Purpose of problem statement. It will take minimum 6 months. Listen very carefully. It will take minimum 6 months to understand your problem. It is not an overnight joke. It is not an overnight task. It will take 6 months to define the problem of research. Purpose of your problem statement, why you want to do study. Previously, it is rightly said, a problem well defined is half solved. You know that. So you may break down your questions into more specific questions. Research problem does not state how to do something, offer broad proposition and present value of questions. It is clearly identify the root cause of problem. It is clearly identified. So identify the purpose of problem. Then how do you write the problem identification? How you can write the problem identification? So is there any way to write, is there any technique available to write the problem identification? Yes, there are many techniques available for writing the problem, for formulating the problem, for defining the problem. Various structure available, writing style available to write the problem, to identify the problem, formulating the problem. And what are the sources of information available to define and formulate the problem? And what makes a good research problem statement? So whenever you are asking a problem, try to do detailed study. Don't ask questions. Ask why. Don't ask what. Ask why. What is the problem identification in research methodology? It is very common for everyone. Let everybody know what do you mean by research and how you can identify the problem. How you can introduce, how you can render the solution of your problem. But should focus on identification of research problem refers to the sense of awareness of prevalent social problem, a social phenomena, and concept that word study as it required to be investigated to understand it. Yes, the most important line, required to be investigated to understand it. Yes, try to investigate, try to go inside, explore all the possibilities. No need to work on problem, but work on solution. No need to work on challenges, convert the challenges into strength. Are you getting my point? Then only you can identify the solution. I said, this is the problem. I said, problem. You never identify the solution. You never create any sense of awareness. Once you clear with your problem and you don't have any option, okay, fine, stop here. Start working on solution. Identify with the help of different techniques. There are various techniques available to solve the problem. So you may take the help of that techniques to solve the problem. On relearn. Learn, relearn. On relearn. You can easily solve the problem, but try to relearn, try to re-earn. You have already learned, but try to relearn. Then only you can solve the problem. Then only you can formulate the problem. The researcher identifies such research problem through his observation. Yes. Try to develop observation skill. As I have already said, according to your skill, according to time, according to resources, according to your knowledge, according to your qualification, and according to your status, you identify such problem. You can take the help of sources. Who said no? You can take the help. There are various software available. There are various free software available. Free access available. You can take the help. And understand how we can define problem, how we can write the problem. The research problem is a statement about an area of concern, condition to be improved. Okay, how you can improve the condition? How you can improve the knowledge? How we can create surety? How we can remove the difficulties? How we can eliminate error? So you may ask certain questions. Surely literature review will give you the specific answer of your questions through theory, through content, through analysis, through statistics. But point need to be discussed in a meaningful order. Understand all the consequences. Understand all the problem. And then you may solve your research problem. And you may write the research problem. what is the purpose of research problem? Why we are doing research problem? Why we are writing research problem? Why we are writing problem statement? Everybody know why we are writing research problem? Why we are writing defining the problem statement? You should introduce the reader to the importance of the topic being studies. Are you getting my point? Communicate. You can pass your message. You just realize reader. You can just see the importance of topic being studied. Place the problem into particular context. Provide a framework for reporting to the result. Place the problem into particular context. That the defined, you should define certain parameter of what is to be investigated. Yes, you should define your investigated parameter. Providing framework for the reporting to the result. You should provide framework. What is the probable necessary to conduct the study? Explain how the findings will be present, this information. Yes, should explain these two important questions. What is probably necessary to conduct the study? And explain how the findings will present this information. So these are the purpose of problem statement. How do you write a problem identification? How do you write? I don't know. People are totally unaware because we never ever go inside and explore how we can write problem, how we can identify the problem. We are working for the solution, ethically or unethically. We are working for the solution, but we never work for the problem. We never understand the problem. We never describe the problem. We never take approval of our guide, mentor, teacher. Related to problem, we never discuss our problem with anyone. Are you getting? Try to communicate, try to take approval. So problem statement is a tool used to gain the support and approval of project from management and stakeholder. Accurate and clearly, it must be accurate and clearly written. What you want to identify. Keep in mind when crafting a problem statement, whenever you are crafting a problem statement, that can have a positive impact on the outcome of project. Yes, that can have a positive impact. But we never work on positive. We never work on positive side. We always work on negative side. We always work on how we can complete our research and when we can complete our research. But try to work on how do you write problem statement. As it is rightly said, describe how things should work. Explain the problem and state why it is matter. Explain your problem financial cost in sense of monetary. Back your claim. Propose your solution. Explain the benefit of proposed solution. Conclude by summarizing the problem and solution. You may conclude by summarizing a problem and solution. So in this way, you may solve your problem. So you can use for the communication tools. It is the important for the business, individual, other entity to develop project focus on the important statement. Also provide important information that crucial in research methodology. Okay. Structure of writing, structure and writing style, as we have discussed earlier, that is first in these are the four conceptualization way of writing research. First is casuist way to solve the problem, means ethical way to solve the problem. You can take the ethics, religious and moral support to determine the problem from right and wrong in the questions context. Second is difference research problem. There are various research problems that you are facing. So you may define your problem into the social science. Okay, and identify the different treatment variable. Descriptive research, you may define the association between different issues. It's very typical questions you may ask. What is the problem? And relational research problem. problem to investigate the specific qualities or characteristic that may be conducted in some different way. So these are in this way you can write or you can structureize your literature. You can structureize your problem. Okay, so this is very important as far as problem identification or formulating problem is concerned. What are the sources of information? That is very common sources of information. I'm not going into the much more detail. Media, blog, personal experience, book, journal. These are the sources of, these are the secondary sources available. So information can come from virtually anywhere. You know that. So you can get the information free of cost, all the information available. You can take the help and write down your problem. You can narrate your problem so that people can understand and you can create some good knowledge in the field of research. 5 steps to formulate your research. Yes, 5 important steps to formulate the research. The first step is called specify the research objective. Should specify research objective. Second, review the environment, either internal or external. Context of the research problem, only in the context of research problem, not in other sense. Third important step, explore the nature of the problem. You should explore the nature of problem. Next, define the variable relationship. You may define the independent dependent interweaving, independent dependent extraneous, independent dependent and controllable. So in this way you have to define the relationship. You can use statistical method, and then the next important is the consequences of alternative cause of actions. So these are the 5 steps. In first month, specify the research objective. Second month, review. Third month, exploring the nature of problem. Fourth, in fourth month, defining the variable. And fifth, consequence. And last, in 6th month, you can write your problem. So this is the cycle. So in this way, you have to formulate your research problem. So please, it is my request to each and every participant, please, whenever you are preparing your research problem, whenever you are drafting your title, whenever you are creating your title, you should focus on these 5 steps of research. I'm not going much more in detail. Okay, I'll definitely share this PPT with you. So do you have a good research problem? Okay, you have to ask very pretty questions. Do a simple self-test. Okay, we have to do to determining the surety. Okay, and so these are the simple self-test which determine and which define your qualities of research problem. Your questions allow for a number of potential answers. Yes, it is testable, flexible, and open-ended. People are free to give answer as well as close-ended also. You have the evidence necessary to address, yes, through literature review. Are you getting my point? You can say that, yes, a researcher has used descriptive research design. Do you have any evidence? You said, yes, I have referred this literature review. Okay, so on the basis of that evidence, you said that we are using, or researcher has used descriptive research design. It is precise and clear. Is transparent. What you want to do, how you want to do, when you want to do, for whom you want to do. You must say in clear and concise manner. You don't use any vague or any unclear term or required definition. No need to define why you are doing. Make sense. Whatever you are writing, whatever you are asking, never ever create any kind of conflict. It is suitable for the length of your paper. You can explain why your solution matter. Yes, you can explain why your solution matter. Are you getting my point? You made premises explicit. So in this way, you may solve your problem and you can say that I am having a good research problem. Okay. After testing all the points, you have to test all the points. It is called self-test of research problem. These are the 4 important components of any problem. These are the 4 important components. First, interesting. Yes. Second, relevant. Specific and focused. Researchable. What should be the formal version be like? Your formal version like in the sense of four important components: interesting, relevant, specific, and focused. Last is researchable. In these four category, you can say that after the any research start with the problem that you derive from the topic that attracts your attention after general reading, classroom, and discussion. Okay, so you can take the help of all four components and solve your problem or define your problem or formulating the problem. Okay, so any questions in formulating problem or identification in problem? Any questions to any participant? You are feel free to ask anytime.
Sir, we'll open this question round for the last.
Not an issue.
Okay.
Fine. Then the most critical part and time consuming part for any researcher, that is review of literature. Can anyone tell me what do you mean by review of literature? Why we are doing review of literature? Can anyone tell me what do you mean by review of literature and why we are doing review of literature?
So that we can know ki jis topic pe hum search kar rahe hain us pe kitni kya kya research ho chuki hai already.
Very good, Garima ma'am, you are absolutely right. Yes, sir.
Searching the relevant literature which is available to this with this study.
Great, sir. Those participants who are not able to speak, they can write your answer in the chat box also, so I can read. So what do you mean by literature review, and what is the importance and significance of literature? Yes, can anyone please tell me?
Good evening, sir. This is Geeta. Main importance of creating literature review will be the identifying the research gap, sir.
Identifying the research gap. Okay, fine, great. I just want to know the significance of literature review. Can anyone tell me the significance of literature review?
It helps to differentiate our study from the earlier presented study.
Yes, absolutely. How you can differentiate? Is there any technique available to differentiate your study? Is there any literature technique available?
Yeah, I think bibliographic study, sir.
Bibliographic study, content analysis. Apart from that, okay, many participants say that it will lead to the further research of topic. Yes, absolutely right. Ignited UPS to identify the existing work into relevant area, right? Absolutely, yes. What is research gap? I'll definitely come to that part also. That part at last I'll cover what actually mean by research gap. Variable identification of the study. Yes, you all are absolutely right. Because of this reason, we are doing literature review. Okay, I'll give you the most important part, most important key elements of literature review. Before entering into the world of literature review, I will tell you the meaning of literature review. Literature review is a critical analysis of a segment of a published body of knowledge through summary, classification, and comparison. So whenever you are doing literature review, it is always based on summary, based on classification, and comparison. So these are the three components of literature review. Do the summary of past study, then may divide into different class, different component, may divide into the different classes, and then you may go for the comparison. And with the help of comparison, you need to narrow down, or you need to define, or you have to define your problem, and you can start your research. So basically literature review is an object, concise, critical summary of published research. Critical summary of published research literature relevant to your topic, irrespective of any topic. Okay, relevant to your topic being researched in an article. It is already published. It is already studied. Okay, it provides an overview of research literature. LR provides an overview of current knowledge, allowing you to identify relevant study. Okay, you should keep key point in your mind. First, theory. Second, methodology. Fourth, research gap. Tell me what the research say in terms of theory. whenever you are writing literature review, whenever writing anything regarding your research, first understand theory, first understand introduction. Second, you should carry out methodology, how the research was carried out methodology. And third, tell me what is missing or the gap that research intend to fill with the help of five key elements. I'll give you the name of five key elements. First key element is search for relevant literature. Second key element is evaluate all the relevant literature. Second element, that is, you have to evaluate with the help of sources, secondary sources. Third, you will have to identify the research gap. What is missing and what is not addressed till now? You should identify research gap. Fourth, outline of your project, outline of your of research. It is called structure. And fifth, called is writing. You have to write your own literature review. Okay, so these are the five key elements. One more time, I repeat same element. First is search. Second is evaluate. Third is identifying. Fourth is outline. Fifth is write. You have to write your literature review for producing more knowledge in the field of research. Okay, because we are producing knowledge with the help of literature review. Okay. How you can get the literature review? Through book, through journal, through report, through research, through thesis, newspaper, or any other way you may get the literature review. Okay, types of review of literature. Basically, there are three types of review of literature. First is evaluative review. Second is explorative review. Third is instrumental review. Maybe it is new for everyone. Okay, maybe it is new for everyone. Whenever you are doing research, you may divide into these three parts. First is evaluative. We never ever do this kind of review. Are you getting my point? We never, including me also, do this kind of review. So whenever you are now onwards, whenever you are doing review of literature, you may divide your review of literature. You will have to do this exercise after the completion of my lecture. You may divide your literature into three parts: evaluating review, explorative review, and instrumental review. Are you getting my point? So according to the theory of evaluating review, it focuses on providing a discussion of review of literature in terms of coverage and contribution to knowledge in a particular area. So it will directly help you out the findings, help you out in the findings. So you may get the with the help of techniques, you may evaluate your review. Okay. Second is you may explore with the help of evidence. So evidential based study. You may ask certain questions. You may use certain technique. You may identify certain unanswered questions to know specific answer. So you can use exploratory review. Then instrumental review, seeking to find out how to conduct some research on a highly specific research problem. Instrumental review. Are you getting my point? So whenever unavoidable cost due to unnecessary, because we don't have much time. So that's why we are never use instrumental review, but we people are using evaluating review and exploratory review. Till now we don't know what is evaluating review. Till now we don't know what is exploratory review, and till now what is instrumental review. Okay, so whenever you are doing literature of review, you may divide your review of literature in these three parts. Now process of literature review. Search for the relevant literature review. Okay. Second is writing the review of literature. So whenever you are defining your problem, okay, first you will try to search the material and sources. If it is available, then you can start research. Fine. Writing the literature review. You may write the literature review. What to review? What is your purpose? You may specify your purpose of review. without any object, you never do the review. You never start process of review. Okay, so you have to specify the process of review. You have to specify the purpose of review. Literature search procedure. How you can search and how you can get the literature review. Planning of research work. You have to plan. Because ultimately you have to carry out research work with the help of evidence, with the help of past study. So most important thing, the key takeaway, whenever you are writing literature review, literature review must be written in a formal and academic style. You know very well. Keep writing clear and concise, avoiding vulgarism that you know, avoid personal language. Try to write in a understanding manner so people can understand and people can respond easily to your questions. Most important literature review, whenever you are writing any literature, you have to ask certain questions to yourself. First, what questions problem is the author addressing? These are the important questions you should ask yourself before doing literature. What questions or problem is the author addressing? Second, what are the key concepts and how are they defined? Third, does the research use established framework? Fourth, what are the relevant and conclusion of the study? What are the result of your study? How does the publication contribute to your understanding of your topic? So whenever you are writing any literature review, you must present in the form of certain questions to define and limit the research, to place your study in historical perspective, to avoid unnecessary duplication, to evaluate promising research method, to relate your findings to previous knowledge or existing knowledge and suggest further research. In this way, you may solve your problem. So literature review is a type of secondary literature that take about previously published work. Literature review give you an overview of existing literature into the field. It will help you to identify specific problem or issue. Analyzing the information for available published work on the topic with a balanced perspective. So these are the important things for the literature review. Whenever you are writing literature review, you know the types of literature. Okay. So in this way, you can write your literature and finally come what to review. Finally come to the next question and last question, what to review? Yes. Okay, you can ask this question to yourself, what to review? I don't know how to review, when to review, which topic I have to study, the kind of literature to be reviewed at the various stage of research process and specific purpose of review are indicating below. You have to see LSAT that part also. Identification, selection of your problem. These are the steps that we have to, and kind of literature to be reviewed. For example, if identification of selection of problem, if you are not able to identify your problem, you can do 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. You can take the help of literature review. Second, formulation of selected problem, previously studied in the field of field and journals available. Operationalization of concept, preparation of research proposal. Are you getting my point? And purpose of review. So in this way, you can do your review. Then construction of tools for collecting of data. I don't know how to construct the data. I don't know which tool I am using. Okay, for the same, there are various kind of literature available to review, and drafting theoretical chapters. I don't know how to draft. Okay, you can take the previous evidence. You can take the previous thesis. You just go in library and take the thesis. Okay, in the sense of journal, in the sense of textbook, in the sense of reference book, report, or we call it as a subject matter or subject material. So in this way, you can write your chapter. So whenever you are writing literature review, you may divide your first, you divide into step, second, kind of literature to be reviewed, third, purpose of review. So you can take the note and compile whole and make one report with the help of a bibliography. So in this way, you can review your literature. Not going into the detail. Steps of literature review. Structure of literature review is very important. Literature review typically has five sections. First is introduction. Second is method. Third is body. Fourth is discussion. Fifth is reference, list of reference. Okay. Now, what do you mean by introduction? Whenever, because anything you are writing, you must follow some structure. Are you getting my point? So, literature review has five sections. First is introduction. Introduction means what? You have set some context. Provide information about field of study. Provide information about your problem. Provide information about your topic. Provide information about the field. Okay, and focus on review of literature. These are important aspects covering introduction. Second, method. Help to reader understand your approach. Describe the criteria used to select the sources. You have to describe why you want to do this study. You have to specify your criteria. How you can specify? Is there any relevant study? Okay, fine. Come and discuss with your mentor. Show me. How you present this information? Are you getting my point? So in this way, you have to structurize your review of literature. So first part is introduction. This is very common. Just do copy and paste and rewrite whole paragraph. Then which method you are using for writing? Third, body of review of literature. A chronological model has different paragraph for different time period. You can use different model and divide that part into subtopics based on the different themes. Okay, according to your topic. Methods. Summarize the main contribution of significant study. You can summarize. Raise and discuss the questions about the topic, field, clear mention gap in the research, and if any problem suggestion and further study. This is we call it as a method. And last, reference list. You have to prepare your bibliography with the help of APA style, American Psychological Association style. Prepare and complete reference list on a chronological order, and that include every important details of all the sources. You may cite them, you may acknowledge them. Are you getting my point? So reference. So these are the five sections of literature review. Whenever you are doing literature review, you should focus on this part, and these are the important part for any researcher, any scholar, or any mentor. Okay. So these are the key elements. Analyzing the critical, summarizing the and don't summarize. Analyze, and you have to analyze the things. Don't summarize. Okay, get the structure right. Rely on feedback. You specify and clear your objective. Avoid sounding as previously researcher. You may avoid. No need to work on the weakness. Try to explore more. Include order of study. These are the final checklist you have to understand. Choose the right topic. Check the literature you have chosen. Take note while reading. Decide the format of your review. And keep the focus specific and interest in general. Okay, so these are the checklists for literature review. Once you did literature review, once you complete your literature review, once you publish literature review, you have to check one by one according to the checklist. So this is called final checklist of literature review, and you have to do this checklist. You have to prepare this checklist. I'm not telling you you have to follow all the steps, but at least you have to follow needed step. At least you have to follow needed things in your topic. And structure of writing literature review. And I'll give you unique literature structure on the basis of review model. Okay, this is called review model of literature review. Okay, review model of literature review. First, R is for relevance. Okay. Second, E stand for expertise of author. V stand for viewpoint of author or organization viewpoint. I stand for intent of audience. E stand for evidence. And W stand for when it published. You have to check validation. You have to check reliability. R is relevance. You have to check the relevance, whether it is completed or not. Does the reference completely cover your topic or not? You will have to ask certain questions. Does the reference completely cover your topic? If it is not, you may change. You may identify. Have you read widely to determine your relevant? It is in the relation to other sources. Relevancy, literature relevancy. Second, expertise of author. You are doing the research in management. You can take the reference of engineering. So you have to check expertise of author. What is the educational background? That's why, at initial, I'll also come to that part also in the format of research report. That's why we have to mention our qualification. That's why we have mentioned our designation. Every aspects have their importance. Every aspects have their importance. What are their qualifications? Are they writing in the area of expertise? Yes, you have to ask. You have to identify. If it is not according to your field, okay, you may change. Suppose you may get the literature review of engineering. Okay, fine. It is not from my field. Okay, you can change. You can identify. You can search according to your requirement. Are the regular cited by other author in the field? Yes, you have to check the citation also. Viewpoint of author. Has the research has been sponsored by organization with interest in the topic? What is the purpose of the sources to inform? So at least you have to entertain the viewpoint also. I intend of audience. Is it intent for the large or small readership? You have to specify the intent. You have to specify the society. You have to specify the aim. Do the detailed study. Do the referencing. Is the reference aim at the general public? Yes or no? If it is yes, okay, you can use. And next is evidence. So this model will help you to render your literature review, to authentize your review of literature. Okay, then W is for when published. When it published, what was the reference published recently? Yes, okay, fine, you can take the help, include in your bibliography. Are you getting my point? Have significant development been made in the subject area since the reference was published? Yes. Significant contribution. You have to check significant contribution in society, in individual, in organization. And if it is contributed, you can take. So, literature review required you to critically evaluate the literature. Literature, one more time I repeat, literature review required you to critically evaluate the literature. So with the help of review criteria, with the help of review model, you can evaluate your literature. Fine? You can evaluate your literature. I'm not going into the detail of questionnaire, okay, but I'll just give you what do you mean by meaning of questionnaire. Question list of questions that are answered by the many people. Questions is used for the collecting information about particular subject. The questionnaire is a research instrument. Questionnaire is a research instrument that consists of a set of questions or other types of prompts that aim to collect information. Okay, so everybody know why we are preparing questionnaire, because of gathering information from the respondents. Okay, and whenever you are preparing any questionnaire, you should first first you have to self-administer your questionnaire, and second, researcher administration. So you have to do verification in two ways. First is self-administrative way, and second is researcher administrative way. Because it is very important from the research point of view. Whenever you are writing your research paper, whenever you are writing anything, you should focus on word. You should focus on relevant. You should focus on unambiguous word. Okay, not open to more than one interpretation. Okay, you should, it is very important for everyone. Take care of this part, unambiguous word. Then specific questions. Ask one question at a time. Okay, so that you can get answer, so that you can enjoy all answered by the response. Objective wording. To get answer, ask questions. Very important quote. To get answer, ask questions. But to get good answer, ask good questions. Yes, it is very simple. Okay, so at least you have to ask good questions to get good answer. Fine. Validity and reliability is also very important. Preliminary of the preliminary decision in questionnaire designing, you have to, these are the steps that you have to take care. In future, we will definitely work on how to design questionnaire or how to draft structure questionnaire with the help of step. We will definitely look into that. And I'll just give you idea about physical appearance of questionnaire. Are you getting my point? We all are talking about our formal dressings. So yes, questionnaire having a questionnaire having their physical appearance, use of booklet, simple color format, clear format, create use of space and typeface, use of color coding, interview instruction. So you should be placed alongside the questions to which they pertain. Interview should probe for more information. Respondents are able to complete a questionnaire. Reduce the number of pages of questionnaire. Clarity of questions. Help in administration of question. Make use of blank space. Are you getting my point? So these are the important qualities and significance of questionnaire. So now the next and last point and last part of the talk. Research paper format. Cover page, abstract, introduction, background, methodology, result, conclusion, appendix, including references. And the main section of typical APA, American Psychological Association research paper include cover page. I'll show you. Cover page, abstract, introduction, background, methodology, result, conclusion, appendix. Fine. So formatting of a research paper that you know very well. Before you start your paper, it is important to know what style guide to use. Okay. Style guide regulate your paper, typography, grammar, citation, and bibliography. Okay, you must acknowledge previous author, different field, use different style, guide into the research study. Okay, APA, MBA, then style guide name, American Psychological Association, as we have discussed, then behavioral and scientific science research. Some basic tips for formatting APA research paper. Paper white paper, 1 point left side, one each margin on top, bottom, and right side. Font in 12 point times New Roman line spacing. You can use double line spacing or 1.5 line spacing. Cover page are required. APA paper and are center aligned, that you know very well. Right align paper number at bottom or right align or bottom align, whatever you are using according to the specified guideline. Background of methodology. So these are the important instructions for writing the research paper. So in this way paper. Whenever you are using APA style, right side, top corner, page number, then paper title, author name, course, affiliation, due date, and instructor. And at bottom line, you can use page number also. Then running head, in heading, you can write your topic name. Then you can use index or APA heading formatting style. Seventh edition, you can use. Then references, section label, double space, web citation, journal citation, hanging indent and book citation. Okay, so in this way you can do the citation. Fine. And it is, I have identified the research in research. बहुत कोशिश के बाद 21वीं सदी में चौथा मिला. ये ना उधर देखेगा, ये ना उधर देखेगा, ना कभी सुनेगा ना कभी बोलेगा. फाइन. एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड दिस यंग रिसर्चर विद द हेल्प ऑफ मोबाइल. आई वुड लाइक टू से थैंक स्पेशल थैंक्स टू द पर्सन. Okay, over to you, Kalyani ma'am. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you so much, sir, for your patience, sir. Excellent and elaborative presentation, sir. It's a wonderful session, sir.
Thank you so much.
Now the session is open for question and answer. If you have any queries, please ask him or please post in the chat box. Use the chat box only for giving your remarks, and please ask any question.
Good evening, sir. I have a doubt. It's not related to this, but I have a query. I want to do research on the topic. Like most of the thing, I have done my BA, and during this internship program, I have seen the counseling is being given only to the girls, like adolescent girls. Why the counseling is not given to the adolescent boys? Why the awareness is not given to the boys about their maturity and the hormonal changes and the behavioral changes or physical changes, what they face? It may be that reason that boys are addicted to like adult content videos or something like that. Am I clear to this research topic, or do I have to do something, research on this topic in some other area?
Do one thing, ma'am. Do one thing. You can send me your research topic or your research area. We can definitely discuss, because it will take time. So first, I want to know your objective. First, I want to know your research title, and then we can discuss. So I can give you better clarity on that part. So rather than I'll give you on that platform, I'll give you my number right now. So you can contact me anytime, and I'll definitely solve your problem. Okay.
Okay, sure, sir. Can I have your number, sir?
I'll just share with you within just wait for 1 minute. I'll just share with you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
You may get my number. You can check. I already.
Any more questions, please?
Hello. Am I audible? I have a question.
Yes, sir, please go ahead.
Let me first of all thank you, sir. It was a very informative session, and I will not be alone in saying that this was a very an exhaustive collection, a meticulous collection and presentation of the information tips regarding the research process, especially the research process, review of literature, APA format, everything. Thank you so much, sir. I mean, it really reduces our time in searching for the content, or it was like reading several books altogether. So thank you so much. I have yet to see a resource person working so much on so much of information, putting it all in this limited period of time.
Thank you so much, sir. It's my pleasure.
So let me come to the questions, sir, quickly, because I see that there are a lot of people who want to ask questions. So yes. My first question would be, like, you have already mentioned this, that is regarding the non-probability sampling, that yes. Under the circumstances that we are moving towards that, like even if I want to do a probability sampling, under the circumstances of this restriction, lockdown and everything, I would have to probably float the questionnaire via email or Google Forms, which some say that, some argue that it is a form of convenient sampling. So that yes. That would be my first. So what can we do in that circumstance?
Sir, it is 100% non-probability convenient sampling, because you are not able to catch all the people. So it is 100% non-probability convenient sampling, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But then I do get an answer like from some people, like they say that even if that is the case, like you are collecting the data, probably you are employing an external agency who will provide you a list of respondents, emails or whatever, but then you are doing, in a sense, it would be a simple random sampling, that you are taking, you're selecting some specific respondents. So in a way, it is a simple random sampling or probability sampling method. So, but my question again would be, should like you have pointed out, it will be a non-probability sampling.
Yes.
So what will I mention when I during the let's say if I'm going to present it in front of panel members, if someone asks, or should I mention it like
yes, so researcher has I'll give you the answer of your questions. Okay, it is really nice questions for each and every scholar. You can directly straightforward mention here researcher has used non-probability convenience sampling method due to some limitation, or in the part of limitation you have to mention due to time constraint, due to unavailability of resources, or due to cost constraint. You have to mention in your literature in your limitation. Okay, but don't forget you have to mention in your limitation.
Mm-hmm. Okay sir. Okay.
Fine. Okay. One question. Yes,
yeah,
sir.
Can I ask one more question? Again, this is regarding the time period of data collection. I have come across very few anyone mentioning about that. So suppose say if I have to, for example, I have to collect data regarding the advertisement. I want to see the customer perception towards a brand with respect to the advertisement of that brand. So now, let's say I have to collect 300 samples. And considering that this is done in the regular situation, not in this present situation, and I'm floating it across the questionnaire across the internet, I mean, through email or anything, but I'm going and collecting in the field. So now collecting 300 samples is going to take some time. So let me say that I have taken a month or 2 months for collecting the data. Now, the problem here is that let's say that advertiser, he has changed advertising. When I collected the data the first month, and now I'm moving to in a different area for the second month, and the advertiser has changed the advertising, let's say. So now would that not introduce an element of error or bias when I collect the data? Now it will not be relevant, I think. So what can I do in such a situation?
Sir, in that case, do one thing. You can do one thing. I'll definitely give you the answer. But I just want to know, okay, what is your problem? Rather than focusing on multiple tasks, you should focus on only one part. Okay, what you want to do. My intent is very clear. Okay, yes, I want to do. I just want to. For example, when I just have quick example bataya tha, okay, domestic violence ka. So it is very broad area. Okay, fine. But I know it is very tough for me to get all the information. Okay, so I can narrate down whole process into the simplest manner. Okay, so do one thing. First, you need to understand what is your objective, and according to the objective, your objective, impact of advertisement, what you want to know in advertisement. So try to identify according to your objective.
Okay, sir. Okay, because this will not be a problem when we are floating the questionnaire through Google Forms.
Sir, do one thing. You can, whatever the query that you are having, you can send me on your on my mail. This is my mail ID, chintansar.mba@gmail.com, and this is my mobile number. You can just note down my mobile number, and you can call me or WhatsApp me your problem. And I request each and every participant, those who are having problem, and if I am not able to give you answer right now of your questions, sorry for that. Okay, but you can message me personally. I'll give you an individual answer of your questions, and we will definitely discuss of your question personally. So this is my personal request to everyone. If you are having questions related to research, related to literature, you can directly contact me on this mobile number, and you can take the help of mail also. You can send me.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
MKG. Can you please repeat your mail ID and phone number?
Okay, sir. Write down my mail ID and write down my mobile number. You can note down my mobile number. It's 99247 99247 300018 Dr. Chintan Sah, 9924730018. This is my WhatsApp number. And my mail ID, chintansa.mba@gmail.com. One more time, I repeat same thing, chintansa.mba@gmail.com. Okay, I'll come to that part also. Sir, Suhas sir, aapne note down kar liya mera number?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. One questions from... Just wait, I'm...
Also, sir, there is one request. Can you share this PPT?
Yes, I'll share with the organizing team and they will definitely mail you. Okay.
Thank you.
From Swapnil, from one of the participants called Swapnil, how could we find the relevant journal for publishing e-paper? Okay, fine. So, sir, rather to give answer of your questions, you can attend last day session and you will definitely get the answer of your questions. Okay, last day session of KU Nayak sir, and he will definitely guide you and he will focus on the part of journal. He cover all the aspects, where to publish, when to publish, and how to identify best journal. Okay, I'll definitely give you the answer, but at least I request all the participants attend last day session because you may get more clarity in the sense of when and where to publish. Fine. Next question, aage questions tha. How do we write effective related to a paper publication and software to enhance and brush up our writing? Okay. So rather than using any software, try to read as many as literature review from IIM, from IIT, from top 100 B school of world class university. You can try to explore their libraries also, free access available, and enhance your or brush up your writing. So I have already said that if you want good answer, you have to ask good questions. Same here. If you want to write good paper, read good review of paper. Okay. And sir, what is the difference between descriptive research and causal research by Jesolit? Okay, sir, I'll give you the answer of your questions. Descriptive research and causal research having one difference. In causal research, you are doing cause and effect relationship, or you are identifying the relationship between two variables, that is independent variable and dependent variable. Okay. And what is descriptive research? Descriptive research means you are doing descriptive analysis of any particular problem, or if you are unclear, or if you want to know any characteristics about any problem, that time you are doing descriptive research. And descriptive research, name itself suggests that you can describe unclear idea, say clear idea, that you can describe with the help of descriptive research. And causal research, I have already cleared you. Then aage questions aaya tha mere paas. I'll try to give you all the answers. How to time manage in doing research work? Okay, at least minimum you have to give 2 to 3 hours daily for reading good literature. First, try to collect good literature from authentic website and start reading. Take the printout and start reading and start writing. Then Nemo Navin sir, absolutely right. But try give at least 2 hours per day for literature review and do the detailed study. How smartly we can find out the gap? Okay, aage questions aaya tha. Sir, what do you mean by research gap? The research gap always, research gap is based on two questions. Research gap is what is missing, what is not addressed. This is called research gap. The problem that researcher would want to see addressed in the research. And simply you have to ask certain questions and problem that has not been answered in an area of specialization. That is called research gap. And why it is established? The need, importance, urgency, and necessity of proposed research project, thesis, or description. That's why research gap is established. So whenever you are identifying any research gap is based on certain elements and try to explore all the elements, and you can get the answer of your problem through the research gap. Okay, and for identifying the research gap, you have to at least you have to identify minimum 100 or 90 literature review. While we are proceeding to go to the research, yes, so it is just only the difference between missing, what is missing and what is not addressed. Okay, addressed by the previous author. Fine. Visakha ma'am ka questions tha ye. Okay. Yes. Any questions from any other parties? Sir, in science area, only descriptive research, suggestible or analysis based paper can be. Yes, ready sir, you can do both the paper, but I'll personally give you the suggestion, you must go with the analyze based paper, so you can get more clarity. How to publish good research? As I have already mentioned in my few minutes ago, Manoj Chaudhary sir, at least you have to attain last day session, you may get the clarity of when to publish, how to publish a research paper.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, Dr. Chintan Shah, sir. And enthusiastic participants are there today. Because of your presentation, they are getting so many doubts and they have resolved it. Thanks for your patience. Now, I request to Mr. Suvachala, ma'am.
Ma'am, just wait. And I would like to request participant, you can call me anytime. I will definitely help you out. And thank you so much. You can see the research gap. Participant gap filled by the St. Mary Secunderabad Institute. Okay. Are you getting my point? They are the inter, means they introduce me to you, and I'll definitely introduce St. Mary to you anytime. If you want any help related to research, you can call me anytime. You can please note down my number, and you can take the number from Kalyani ma'am also. Thank you. Over to you, organizer.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now I request Mr. Suvachala, ma'am. She's the HOD of BCom Generals of our college, to give the concluding remarks of the session.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, one and all. On behalf of the management, staff, and participants, I would like to thank and congratulate our honorable speaker, Dr. Chintan Ajay Bhai Shah, for his successful session. It was really interesting the way you explained with examples, sir. And you were so patient in clearing all our doubts. And you enlightened us on various aspects like research process and sampling techniques, problem identification and its formulation, and research paper formats. And you have given more insights on the literature review, sir. I feel like that was the highlight of the session. And I personally feel that this would really help PhD aspirants. And this knowledge would be an easy gate pass to pass through. Looking forward for many more sessions like this in future, sir. My heartfelt gratitude to you on behalf of everyone, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.